So you downloaded Epic Games Launcher Installer from the official website, which is an MSI file. You run it, the setup starts to install something, but then throws you an error. The Epic Games Launcher Setup Wizard ended prematurely. That's what she said. The reason why this happens is your Windows installation is bloated. And to install the launcher, we need to do a few things. The first thing to do is to make sure that Fast Startup is disabled in your Windows Power Plan. So open Power Plan, then click on Change What Power Buttons Do, and if you have a tick on Turn On Fast Startup, click on the shield icon, untick the settings, save everything and reboot. Don't worry, your computer will not boot slowly. In fact, without this feature, it may even boot faster, and without this feature turned on, every time you boot, you get a fresh Windows session as opposed to a session that contains some old things from your previous session. So if you only turn on your computer and then shut it down through Windows Start menu or the power button, and you have this Fast Startup turned on, that means you're always in a bloated Windows session. You can clear it up if you select Restart from the Windows Start menu power setting, but you normally don't do that. After restart, try launching the setup again, and if you still have this error, and you did have Epic Launcher installed previously, we need to clear that up. In some cases, the launcher can offer you to delete it. In other cases, you have to go to Windows Apps and delete it from there. You may also want to delete everything from Epic Games from both Program Files and Program Files 86 folders on your computer. And in some cases, you will need a third-party utility, like Reverb Uninstaller, for example, to uninstall Epic Games. You have to uninstall both the Epic Games Launcher and the Epic Games Services. After that, restart the computer and try running the launcher again. If you get the same error, try installing Epic Games Launcher not from Epic's website, but from Microsoft Store. It will download exactly the same MSI package, but from Microsoft servers. And by the way, if you open Microsoft Store in a browser, it will offer you to download something, which will be an .exe file as opposed to MSI file. So .exe is a shortcut from executable, while MSI is Microsoft Software Installer. But this file is actually a link wrapped into an executable file, and when you run it, it will still open the Microsoft Store, offering you to install from there. If none of that helps, we need to run the MSI installer with administrative privileges. Trouble is, by default, Microsoft File Manager doesn't offer you such an option. So we will have to use run command. And while we are here, I want to show you something. So click Browse on the run command. Don't forget to change the file types to all files, otherwise you will not see the .msi file. Navigate to the folder where you have the Epic installer downloaded and select it. If somewhere in the path to this file there are special symbols or a space, so the folder name is two words, for example, the resulting path will be in quotation marks. However, unfortunately, Windows run command doesn't have an option to execute a file with administrative privileges. So what you need to do is to open Task Manager. The easiest way to do so is to press Ctrl-Alt-Del on your keyboard and then select Task Manager. And there, click on Run New Task. A Create New Task window will appear, and this one does have an Administrative Privileges option, which you need to tick. Select the same installer, and in some tutorials online, they also mention that you need to run msiexec.exe. So let's try doing that. Scroll to the left of the path name, type in msiexec.exe, and also don't forget a space between the exe and the path. Try launching it with administrative privileges. Unfortunately, it doesn't work. So what you need to do is to just create a new task, just select the Epic installer, don't forget to tick create this task with administrative privileges, and press OK. This time the Epic installer should install just fine. And during the process, it will try to download update. So even though we just have downloaded the Epic installer, there is already an update to that. Anyway, if you still have an error, that means that there are some problems with your network connection, since the installer cannot reach the internet, thus it cannot download the update, and that's why it throws you this setup wizard ended prematurely error. So you need to fix your internet connection. In some cases, it is very easy. You just select Reset Network from Windows Settings and then reboot your PC, and it should clear things up. But in other cases, you will need to use VPN just to download the installer. After you are done, you can disable the VPN. There are a million VPN services around. Most of them are very easy to use. Some of them offer some free plans, so you'll figure it out. If you don't want to use VPN, but you do have a mobile data plan from your carrier, that means you already do have an alternative internet connection, and you can tether internet from your mobile phone to your computer just during the Epic Launcher setup, so it can download the update. After it's done, you can turn off the mobile internet, untether your phone, and use your normal ISP connection. So that is how you fix this Epic installer error.
I'm the god of YouTube!
Like, subscribe, jingle bells.